What is up, ladies and gentlemen of the YouTubes? My name is LCD, and today I wanted to show you guys my new computer build that I'm setting up here pretty soon. Just got the parts in from Newegg today. I ordered next day delivery because, you know, I'm impatient, and who really wants to wait 3 to 5 days for your new fancy technology, right? I don't think anyone does. So next day delivery cost me an extra $100, but who cares, right? So as you guys can see over here on my bed, this is my old computer. I'm still using like an old 2002, 2003 Alienware case. Look how messy it is inside here. Wires are all taken out. I already took out the graphics cards. I had two GTX 760s and SLI in here, but I already took them out before I made this video because I wanted to already start the process. But, you know, I still got the i7-4790K, 8 gigs of DDR3. I got a 500 gig hard disk drive here, and then I also have a 200 gig SSD right here, which you guys can't see. But over here, I'm just going to combine parts from my old build, combine with the brand new parts, which include a 250 gig Samsung SS850 SSD. One of the new NZXT H440s designed by Razer, which I think is pretty cool. I'm a pretty big Razer fanboy. I'm a pretty big fan of the way their stuff looks. It's also pretty functional as well. I got a Razer Black Widow Ultimate. I got a Razer Car Carriers headset there that I've had for like 4 years now. It's still in great shape, still works great. And over here, I'm pretty excited about this, is the BenQ XL 24-inch gaming monitor. It's got a 1 millisecond response time. It's 3D capable. It's full 1080p. Well, I guess that's it. you know, it's 3D vision ready. The really cool thing about this monitor that I'm really looking forward to is the 144 hertz monitor, as well as the 1 millisecond response time, because I've never had a monitor this fast before. For comparison, the two monitors that you guys are looking at right now, which are the two LG 20-inch monitors, those have a 14 millisecond response. I'm not really gaming monitors, kind of bought them because they're really cheap. So it's going to be a huge difference going from a 14 millisecond to a 1 millisecond response time. Best monitor I could find. It cost me about $350 to $400, so I'm excited to hook these bad boys up. And last but not least is the new graphics card that I just bought, that just came out, the brand new GeForce GTX 980 Ti. And of course, you can see I bought the super clocked edition, which includes a backplate, 6 gigabytes of GDDR5 RAM. So I'm very happy. Best graphics card on the market. And you guys are probably asking, why didn't I get two of them? Well, I loved SLI, but I feel like it's always more important to go with a single powerful GPU card. I didn't have that great of an experience with the SLI simply because there's a lot of micro stuttering. There's a lot of, you know, frame tearing still. I don't have a G-Sync monitor. So really great to be able to finally be able to play games at the highest frame rates, at the ultra settings, with this single card. I've heard a lot of good things about the 980 Ti. I've done a lot of research on this card, and it's just a monster. It's basically a GTX Titan X for $300 cheaper. So $700 graphics card. Hopefully it does me well and I didn't get a defective one. But that's it, ladies and gentlemen. Once I actually hook up the once I actually hook everything up, I'll do another video. Well, I'll edit this video on top of the other video so you guys can actually see the finished product and show you guys how good it looks. I guarantee you it's going to look a whole lot better than that green Alienware did. So stay tuned, guys. I'll be right back. All right, boys and girls, we are getting a little closer here. I've been working on this thing for about an hour now, and it's been taking a lot longer than I thought it would, simply because of the fact that I was messing around with my SSDs and my my mechanical drive, and you guys can't see very well in there, but there's some SSD slots right on the front of the case, right above the power supply mounting area. And what I had to do was actually put them all in the same drive bays because of the fact that I couldn't mount them in the front, so I was dinking around with that for a little bit. But I'm kind of disappointed about that. However, things are moving a little quickly now. The last things I got to do is actually just plug in the graphics card and hook everything up with the power cables. So the next thing I wanted to do is show you guys the graphics card. This is the GTX 980 Ti WinForce Edition from EVGA. This is the super clocked edition, so it actually cost me like an extra $50 to $60 than the normal base clock you would get on the reference card, which is about 1000 megahertz. I think this is boost clocked at about 1200 megahertz, so definitely a huge difference there. I'm not a big fan of like manually overclocking CPUs and GPUs myself, so when I can pay a little bit of extra money to have the factory do it, I will. So this is it. Nothing too fancy. I'm about to plug this bad boy in. See, you guys get the, it's got the dual wind force fans here. I'm a big fan of that simply because I don't usually do water cooling and things like that. So the extra fans and cooling really does help me out a lot. So there you guys have it. Quick little update. And the next video you'll see is the finished build. So you can see, ladies and gentlemen, this is my finished build product, Razer NZXT H440, and it looks great. For some reason, the LEDs aren't working. I might have overlooked that when I was plugging everything in, but it's supposed to come with green LEDs on the front of the case and the bottom of the case as well, so it actually has that underglow feel to it. Maybe I'll go back and fix that eventually, but I'm kind of lazy right now. But it looks it's a solid steel case. It looks fantastic. Really, one little cool thing I like is that inside you can actually see the GeForce GTX 980ti cord, which looks amazing. So I'm really happy for it. It was only a $150 case. I thought it was going to be at least $200, $250. So I got a pretty good deal on Newegg, and I like how it turned out a lot. Here's my new BenQ monitor. It is the 24-inch, 1 millisecond response time, 144Hz monitor. You can actually see how big it is in comparison to my other monitor, which is only a 20-inch monitor, and it has a 14-second response time, or a 14-millisecond response time. So I'm really looking forward to seeing how much of a difference it is as far as like actual playing fighting games and things like that, and first-person shooters on it. So this is the finished GTX 980Ti super clocked build. Haven't gotten a chance to play any games on it. As you can see, I'm actually transferring some of my popular games like The Witcher 3 and Tomb Raider over to my new SSD, 256 gig Samsung SSD. So this is actually going to be my second SSD. My first SSD is 120 gig, which is technically my boot drive, and then I have an actual 500 gigabyte mechanical drive for my mass storage drive. So there it is, ladies and gentlemen. Not too much to talk about. Also, back here you can actually see my green screen and some of the stuff. I'm going to be making a little bit of a backdrop here when I record my YouTube video. So that monitor is going to be used to actually put like logos and things like that on that monitor when I'm actually recording video. So it'll look a little bit more fancy. You can kind of tell I'm out of breath because I've just been running around and trying to get everything done as fast as possible. It took me about 3 hours to build everything together. As you guys can see, I'm kind of a Razer fanboy. My Razer Aatrox for Xbox One, my Razer mechanical keyboard, my Razer mouse, my old Alienware mousepad. I actually wanted to buy that new Chroma Razer mousepad because this one sucks. My Razer car carrier's headset, which I've had for about 3 to 4 years now. It's been working flawlessly. And there you guys have it. If I could buy Razer monitors, I probably would. But thank you all so much for tuning in. Hope you guys enjoy my new build, which I'll be using to make, obviously, my YouTube videos for and my live streaming. So I'll see you guys soon. Thanks for watching. So this is going to be the final part of the build video for the GTX 980 Ti Superclocked Edition from EVGA. And as you guys can see, we're running some Witcher 3. The full specs of my computer will be in the description below. But I did install this on my brand new 256 gig Samsung SSD, so there wouldn't be any like texture issues or, you know, screen tearing or stuttering, hard drive stuttering, anything like that on my mechanical drive, which is really, really nice to have SSDs to put your games on so that they run basically as smooth as possible. So as you guys can see here, I am in, I'm probably like 5 or 10% into The Witcher 3. I've been playing this pretty slowly, doing all the side quests and things like that ahead of time. But let me go and show you guys that I am running this on ultra settings. So go to video, graphics, everything is set to ultra except for Hairworks. I turned that off, obviously. Hairworks just destroys any video card, even the Titan X and the GTX Titan and the GTX 980 Ti. So there's no reason to have that on. Otherwise, everything else is set to ultra, as you guys can see here. Pretty nice stuff. Set to 1920 by 1080 resolution simply because those are what my monitors support. I was actually thinking about getting a 1440p monitor, but after some hard thinking, I decided against it simply because most things are 1080p these days, and you know, trying to run games at 1440p would just hurt my frames. So I'd rather just destroy 1080p resolution than actually try to, like, you know, lose frames trying to play 1440p games. Although I've heard that the 980 Ti destroys 1440p as well, depending on what the game is, obviously. So post-processing, everything is set to high as well. Even HBAO is turned on as well. Ambient occlusion, so good stuff here.
As you guys can see on the bottom right-hand side of your screen, using the Steam in-game FPS counter, it's sitting at about 60 frames per second. I am recording this via XSplit, so that's probably taking away a couple of frames here, but nonetheless, it should be running pretty smoothly if I wasn't recording. But I don't have any traditional like GPU benchmarking software or anything like that, so this is what you guys have to deal with. I'm kind of a novice at this stuff. But looking pretty good. I enjoy it. I'm finally glad that I'm able to play this game at maximum settings at 60 frames per second, as compared to what I was running previously, which was two GTX 760s in SLI. Granted that my two 760s were the 4GB editions as well. Those were super clocked editions as well. So huge, huge leap from the two 760s in SLI to the single 980 Ti. Just amazing beast of a card. I cannot wait to play Batman Arkham Knight when that game comes out. I actually got it for free with the purchase of this graphics card. I already have it installed and ready to go on Steam, which is really nice. So if you guys are thinking about buying a graphics card anytime soon, I would definitely do it before Arkham Knight comes out, because it is free if you guys buy any 900 series graphics card. 960, 970, 980, 980 Ti, the Titan X, it's all free. So that's really, really awesome. So the next game I want to show you is actually Tomb Raider. It's one of my favorite games of all time. So let's go ahead and switch over to that real quick. So here we are in Tomb Raider real quick to do the quick benchmark test. So we're going to go into the graphics settings here, show you guys that everything is set to maximum. Exclusive full screen is turned off. V-Sync is turned on. Triple buffering, so that way we can actually... I probably should turn triple buffering off so you guys can see how much of a frame rate we can actually get. But I usually like to play with V-Sync on for my games, especially when I can make sure I can stay at 60 the whole time. So everything else is set to Ultra. We have Tress FX turned on, anti-aliasing set to FXAA, and everything else is on and set to Ultra. So let's go ahead and run the benchmark. Okay, so right now we're sitting at about 114 frames per second. Again, this is at 1080p resolution. Again, for reference, when I was running these games on my 960 SLIs, I was only averaging about 60 frames per second, sometimes less, depending on the situation. That was with Tress FX on. But it looks like we're getting some pretty good frame rates here with the 980 Ti. Man, I love this game. Tomb Raider is one of my favorite games of all time in the last couple of years. I beat it on the 360, I beat it on the Xbox One version, I beat the PS4 version, I beat the PC version. I'm actually running through the PC version again right now as I speak. And it's just such a fun game. I can't wait for Rise of the Tomb Raider to come out on Xbox One later this year. Hopefully it gets a PC release as well, but I know they got that timed exclusive deal or whatever. But I really want to play that sequel on PC, so let's hope it happens. So my minimum FPS was 80, my max FPS was 146, and the average was 115. So not bad. That is the power of the 980 Ti, ladies and gentlemen. Hope you all enjoyed it. My name is LCD. If you guys like to see future videos like this in the future, let me know by hitting the like and subscribe button. And I will see you guys next time. Thanks for watching, and I hope you guys enjoy my YouTube videos and my live streams with this new setup. Peace out.